Hello, this is Jake with Reverb, here to talk to you guys today about some of my favorite Bob Marley bass lines as played by Aston Family Man Barrett. Aston Barrett grew up in Kingston, Jamaica, and he was kind of the unsung hero of the Wailers band. He produced most of the records, and he was responsible for a lot of the arrangements. Aston played bass in the Wailers alongside his brother Carlton, and the dynamic between the two of them was responsible for a lot of the feel that we know of as reggae today. His bass of choice was a jazz bass. Today we're playing on a P bass with some nice flat wounds, going through an Ampeg B15. Now, one thing of note off the bat is his picking style. A lot of the way that Aston would pick notes is right up here, close to the neck, because you get a much thicker sound than in the middle or down here by the bridge.
Get up, stand up. Stand up for your right. Get up.
Get a sense of Aston as an arranger on this song. One of the first things that stood out to me was the interplay between the bass and the melody. There's kind of a call and response right off the bat in the chorus, right? So you've got this,
get up, stand up for your rights. Get up, stand up, don't give up the fight.
Something of note too, not just on this recording, but on all the songs that we cover today, is really capturing the feel that you can only really get from listening to the recording and studying them closely. So in the verse, it's notated as this triplet figure, but he's laying it farther back than that behind the beat. So it's a little bit more like one, two, three, four. The three in particular is early. It almost wants to land a little bit before where the beat would be, just in terms of how it lines up with the triplets. It's really cool, but it takes a little bit of practice to get down with it.
Was I Jean Sherry? But I didn't shoot no deputy. It was I Jean Sherry. But I didn't shoot no deputy.
Similar to the last example, one of the things that I really love about Aston's style is the feel that he has with his eighth notes. There's a particular swing that to my ear really places an emphasis on the later beats in a measure, so like beats 3 and 4, instead of the earlier ones. So you hear it right off the bat. A little push there. One of my favorite quirks in reggae music is this idea of the one drop, which is where you don't play beat one, the band doesn't, particularly the rhythm section, bass and drums, and instead you put the emphasis on beat 3. So you hear it a lot with a kick and like a rim click on beat 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And Aston kind of emphasizes this in the verse here with this octave figure where he's ducking right after beat two to let beat three really have some oomph with the drums. 2, 3, 4. Right, so each time right off the bat, he's getting out of the way so that that three can really be big and felt by the rest of the band. I wanna love you, I wanna love and treat you right. I wanna love you, 'cause every day you pass on every night. Gotten a chance to talk too much about Aston's melodic playing, but I think this song really shows it off to a very cool effect. With this F sharp minor pentatonic figure right off the bat. And he outlines a D major 7 arpeggio. With that fun little figure there. Something that I always thought was really cool about this song is what happens every time they start the chorus off. It's a 3-bar phrase. Gives it just a little bit of oomph into the rest of the chorus by cutting off a measure. And it's something I never really noticed until I tried to play it, because the actual chorus has this figure every time that they play it, right? But that's a 2-bar phrase. So what they do instead is they just give it a little bit of room to give that oomph forward. The other thing is in the latter half of the chorus, you really hear the feel of Aston's eighth notes and his triplets. Right? Particularly the eighth notes, they're not straight. No, that would be lame. Same with the triplet again. It's pulled back on the beat this wonderful way. Lastly, let's talk about the song One Drop off the 1979 record Survival, with a name that references the rhythmic figure that we were talking about before, the one drop. The one drop. And we still find time to rap. We're making the one stop. The generation gap. The field is found. The song really encapsulates a lot of the things about Aston's style that we covered today. We've got the swung eighth notes, right? His distinct. That would not sound cool if we played it. Right? Sounds kind of like a polka band or something. Each time he starts a phrase, he leaves out beat one. 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 There's a melodic idea to the whole phrase. He's outlining a lot of chords with these arpeggios, but it's not the exact same shape each time, right? On this G, the last chord, I guess you would call it a first inversion because the lowest note he's playing is a B. And it's the same thing for the entire song. This man's got a lot of patience and respect for the groove. And this is one of the things that made me want to talk about him most of all. Now that was just the tip of the iceberg, not just for Aston's style, but for all of reggae. He's a world-class bass player who continues to play with the Wailers to this day. If we didn't cover one of your favorite bass lines of his, please let us know in the comments. This is Jake with Reverb, signing off. We'll see you next time.